oil and gas, we believe it's needed and it's required for the transition. Affordability for the consumers is something that people are not talking about. But affordability to the consumers is very important. There are people who doesn't have access to electricity. It's just not fair not to provide them with electricity or to reduce or curtail the fight oil and gas and say, then the prices would go higher. And if the prices goes higher, those consumers will be complaining. They are going to pay the price. So I think we need to be practical. We need to be increasing the world requirements for fossil fuel during the transition if we are serious to reach 2050 with zero emissions. We need to fight not the oil and gas, in my view. We need to fight the emission from the oil and gas. That's exactly what Dr. Sultan and his team have done in ADNOC. They were the first company, oil and gas company, to adopt clean energy, clean electricity sources in the production of oil. If you look at the carbon intensity in every barrel that produce, the methane and the zero flaring policy, UAE was among the first countries to utilize the gas and adopt a zero flaring policy. So all of these strategies and real projects, I think they give the credential to the country first, to its leadership, and to whoever they nominate. And Dr. Sultan, he was, as I said, in Masdar. And when he came to ADNOC, and since he came to ADNOC, he have done a great job in making our barrels much, much greener. And I hope others are just doing what Dr. Sultan is doing in ADNOC. I think if those producers in different parts of the world adopt the same policies that we have, the whole oil and gas sector will be much, much cleaner than it is today.